Hello friends, welcome to Duke series, Duke is Do You Know series. Today we will see a battle between development and ecology. So development is important, but at the same time there is a balance of ecological balance which we need to maintain. So this particular news report, let's decode this news report. News report stands at coastal road project. BMC seeks not to move 18 coral colonies. So today we will try to understand about what is a coastal road. See some beautiful coastal roads also. What's BMC? And what's this 18 coral colonies? So this is the geography of coastal road which we are talking at the moment. This coastal road project is being planned in Mumbai. So this is the coastal stretch of Mumbai that will be covered under the coastal road, and the stretch is planned to be 29.2 kilometers with 8 lanes, so basically 4 lane one side and 2 dedicated bus lane, so 1 dedicated bus lane each side. What's the green zone impacted? So see, when the road is being done here, there is always a presence of other living organism in the and the ecology and the ecosystem here. So this particular thing gets disturbed and there is a impact. So the total area which they think or the project says impacted will be 180 hectares, of which 91 hectares only will be resettled, so balance will be lost. And the most impacted in this would be coral colonies. So we'll understand what is coral and what does coral colonies also mean. These coral colonies are protected like any other wildlife under Wildlife Protection Act 1972 of India. So friends, this is a coastal road. Coastal road is generally built along the coast. It runs in parallel with the coast, sometimes over the ocean also in many places. It is used, like in Norway, it was used to connect islands, and it hopped between islands and skerries. So some of the beautiful coastal roads across the world, we have Highway 1 Big Sur in California. It's a Pacific coastal line of America, 140 kilometers in length, and it's one of the very renowned tourist destination. Then there is a Florida Keys 7 Mile Bridge. It's a very famous bridge. It runs over the stretch on an ocean patch, and it's 10.9 kilometer in length, and again it is a very renowned destination for tourists. Then this is a very typical road. It's called Atlantic Road, Norway. It's in Norway. It is basically 8.3 kilometers length, and it is built on several islands and skerries. So you can see there are islands here which are basically cut connected using this road. So this is a very beautiful coastal road. You should find out more. So there are many such coastal roads beautifully built across many countries. They serve as good tourist destination and bring revenue to those countries, and also they connect and make transportation very fast. So the main reason why coastal roads are thought about by countries is to make the traveling fast and smooth, and less traffic is there to reduce the traffic and the manage the whole population. Further, it adds is if the scenic views which add to their tourist footfalls, where people do visit, and that's one of the agenda of visiting amongst the other destinations. Now, what is BMC? BMC is Brand Mumbai Municipal Corporation. So it is a municipal corporation which manages city of Mumbai. So it does all the construction, beautification, police, and many other things are covered by BMC. It's very old. It was founded in 1888. Mumbai mayor is Kishori Pednekar. Commissioner is Iqbal Chachal. He's an IAS officer. And BMC is considered as one of the richest municipal corporation in India. And also it has held that position at Asia level also. So you can see the revenue earned by Mumbai Municipal Corporation stands at 24,924 crore. And if you compare other cities, they are very small. So Mumbai is in fact 6 times that of Pune. So it's really revenue wise, if you see, a lot of revenue which Municipal Corporation of Mumbai earns. Now, what is coral colony? Coral colonies are the corals, which is a marine life. So it's a marine invertebrate which attach themselves to the rocks. So you can see these are the rocks and these are the corals, and they attach themselves to the ocean or the rocks in the sea and the ocean. They are very, very important part of the marine life. In fact, not even marine life, overall they are very important. They reduce the shock waves and the wave energy generated by the ocean. They reduce the impact of storms, tsunamis, and many other calamities like this. Further, they support so many species per unit area. It's largest compared to any other ecological being, if you say. They support like 4,000 types of fishes at least per unit area. And 800 hard corals. So there are two forms of corals. One is in hard coral and another are soft corals. Hard corals are where they basically take calcium from the ocean and they become really hard because they have a lot of calcium content, just like our bones. And there are soft corals, which are more like soft flesh animals and plants. And they also support many other species other than fishes, and so there might be small insects and other things which they support. Mumbai has 11 species of coral, and they are spread over 8 locations across Mumbai, so say Haji Valley and these kind of coastal areas. You should find out which type of corals do exist in Mumbai, and they were very good at some point of time, but maybe due to pollution some of them would have died. So a lot of damage would have already happened. These are the coral reefs across the world. This is one very famous coral reef. It's called Great Barrier Reef. It's the largest coral reef. You can see there is a satellite image. So this reef you can see from space. So this is the only reef you can see really from the space. It stretches for 2,300 kilometers. And over an area of 2,14,000 square kilometers. They exist off the coast of Queensland, Australia, in the Coral Sea. So the sea itself is called Coral Sea. And they are the only one visible out there. The nearly 3,000 individual reefs exist. So each of these might be a reef. The reef is like a colony of corals. And these are the underwater images, if you can. Really beautiful. If you can go and see, and if not damaged, they will still exist. But as the pollution is increasing across the oceans and human activity is increasing, many coral areas are getting destroyed, which include Mauritius and Maldives, and these places were rich in coral. But as the tourist and other activities have increased a lot, construction and all, because of which bleaching of coral has been happening. So the coral reef bleaching is the name which is generally used for pollution and the deaths of corals. So basically corals bleach and death happens. They are very important part of marine life. We should all see and understand how this balance should be kept continuing. So for example, Mumbai is, that's the report, Mumbai BMC is trying to shift 18 coral colonies from the location where the construction is happening to another location in the sea or ocean so that they still survive and the balance continues. So that is it with the presentation on this particular news report. Hope you enjoyed. do meet us again in DUK series. Thank you.